Hi, welcome to this Accofina tutorial on financial calculator tips and guides. We're going to talk about the Texas Instrument BA2 Plus, and in particular, setting the begin and end modes and why each of these modes matters. Okay, so here are the steps written out. I'm going to go through a live demonstration after these steps, and then we'll come back at the end and talk about why they matter. So to toggle between begin and end modes, first of all, you press second to access the shift or second function. Then you press begin, which is above the payment or PMT button. It should now display begin or end to show you what mode you're currently in. Then you press second, and then you press set, and that'll toggle you between begin mode or end mode. And then once you have your mode that you want, you press the clear button, and that will take you back to your standard workspace with your new mode inside. Okay, here's our demonstration of using the begin and end modes. So we have a Texas Instruments BA2 Plus here, and it's already been turned on. And what we're gonna do is push the second button, which is this one up here, it says second. And then we have to push the BGN button, which is, you can see, it's above the PMT. So we push second to access the shift button, and then just push PMT, and it'll show that we are in end mode. And to toggle between them, you push second again, and then the enter button up here, and that'll switch you between begin and end mode. Push it again to get back to end mode, push it again to get back to begin mode. Now it's important to note that when you're in begin mode, you'll have a BGN warning at the top here. If you're in end mode, there's just nothing there. But if you're in begin mode, it'll say BGN. And this is a gentle reminder that you're in begin mode. Now, most time value money problems need you to be in end mode. That's the normal question, and the majority of questions will have you in end mode. So what it does is it tells you that if you put it in begin mode, it'll give you the gentle reminder that you're in begin mode. And unless you're being asked to use begin mode, to set it back to end mode. And that's just why they have the BGN up there, I believe. Okay, CEC to get back to our workspace, and that is our demonstration. Okay, so why do begin and end modes matter? Well, in the financial world, annuity products and contracts can vary depending on when payments are made. A standard annuity is when payments and cash flows occur at the end of the period. That's like maybe a home loan repayment or savings account interest. So you make the payment at the end of the month, or you receive the interest at the end of the year or so forth. On the other hand, there's an annuity due. This is when payments and cash flow occur at the beginning of the period. This could be like a rental property or other lease contracts, or even something just like a cable TV contract. That's where you pay upfront for the month in advance, and then the following month or following period, the following period, you again pay at the beginning of the period, and that'll cover you going forward. But either way, the different timing of these payments is affected by the time value of money. And that's when you calculate the annuity's values. This time value of money difference means that the values will be different. So in short, the end mode is for annuities when payments are at the end, and the begin mode is for annuities due when payments and cash flows occur at the beginning. Okay, that's it. I hope it helped. Best of success. There's your fireworks. If you enjoyed the video, please share or subscribe. Please watch another. There's buttons popping up on the screen now that you can do any of those things, or even just give me a thumbs up. And finally, feel free to comment below if you have any questions or need clarification, or even just to say hello to me or your fellow peers and stir up a discussion. Okay, thanks very much.